With a nourishing breakfast out of the way, it's time once again to head into the canyon.
This is part of the old wagon road that's so hard to see on the other side. We're on the highway side now, and it's still a recognizable road. I'm going to head down here for a ways and come to a pool.
Well, there's not going to be any true getting into the real canyon without crossing the river. But I can get to the very edge of the canyon, just the downstream part of the canyon, the site of the old bridge crossing, which washed out over 100 years ago.
Well, we're still on the road. We're getting a little closer to the hole now. Road's getting a little harder to define. But the river's right down there. We're getting close.
Okay, well, you know, I hope Chris is having a great time. I hope he's having success, because I kind of got my itch scratched with the old bush bashing, going through the woods, like crashing and snapping twigs the whole way, and then straight down into the canyon, got all muddy, dirty. I just, you know, I'm glad he enjoys it. I'm so happy he enjoys that. I don't. But it was an adventure, and it was worth having once. And now I'm going to do, while he's working hard fishing and going through the canyon, I'm going to show you how I work hard here at camp. Now, don't get me wrong, I have chores, and they're done. And now I do some other hard work, so I'm going to share that with you right now.
Darcy was hard at it too, and she kept it up all day long, she said.
Yeah, we're getting to the end of where you can define it as a wagon road. It comes right past me here. And pretty much disappears. I know where it comes out on the other side of the river, but that's unapproachable today. Well, we finally got to the pool. Now we just have to see if it has trout in it. And I know just how to find out.
Well, here's how we find out. I got a dandy piece of worm here. And we'll see if there's any fish in here. Don't want to fall in. We really found one. He's a nice fish. He's 10 or 11 inches. Native trout. Okay, now we're going to see if we can wake him up. Look at that rooster tail. That ought to get any trout in here excited. Just reel it in nice and enticingly.
and nothing. That's a disappointment. We'll try it again. There we go. He was a little more excited about it. Another nice fish. He's a good one. He's 10 or 11 inches. Breakfast. But not today. We'll see if there's another one out there. We're gonna go after the big one this time. You know? Let's try our old buddy, the Thomas Boyan. See if this will bring us any luck. You gotta be careful kissing a lure, it's got treble hooks on it.
Now the rod I'm using here is an ultralight trout rod, and the line is 4-pound test.
I don't know what it is, but it's great fish.
At this point, I was just hanging on. I could tell the fish was a lot bigger than a foot-long trout, but what was it?
I hope we get to see this fish. This is a fish. This is a monster fish.
All I could do was hang on.
This is the biggest fish I've ever hooked. I don't know what it is, but it's huge. It's huge!
Wow, a salmon. What was he doing here? I didn't know it, but some years ago, the Game Commission started trucking salmon around the dams and releasing them upstream. I'm not sure why they're doing this, but at the moment, it didn't matter.
Look at that! How about that for a fish? North Santa Am. On a Thomas Boyan. See that? And there it pulled out that easy. How about that for a king daddy?
Nearly 15 pounds on light line. That's as good as it gets.
I might as well quit now. I'm not going to top that. I'm not going to. That's it.
That was it. I was done. I decided to go look to see if I could find the last piece of the old road.
Now I finally got on it. Should be a little easier from here. Still on the wrong side of the river for where I found all the artifacts, but it goes right out to there. Kind of to the end of the old road. I didn't think I'd find it anymore, but this is where, right here, just ahead of us, is where the bridge used to be. And right over there, 200 feet away, or 100 miles. Boy, it would be hard to get there. That's down through the old patch, down the canyon. Can't do it today. But anyway, over there, just 200 or 300 feet, there's a whole wagon load of artifacts. I'm not gonna get there today.
As I've said, I've hiked into and fished this stretch of river for over 60 years, and though there's no reason to say how old I am, maybe I could toss out a hint. With the forests locked up the way they are, I may never get to hike down into my private stretch of river again.
This used to be an old wagon road. Every once in a while, here's an old steel rim off a wagon wheel. I come up here and find this kind of stuff. And I always give it a big push down off the trail. Maybe it'll stay there for a while.
Well, as near as I can tell, this is the site of where the old Folsom freight wagon got scrapped out after running off the road here in 1906. It was easier just to part out most of it than to drag it back out of the canyon, I guess.
I found a bunch of those up here, probably 5 or 6. Also, there's a wagon axle.
And I've thrown some of the stuff into the brush myself just to...
We'll find more stuff on down the trail.
Keep it away from prying eyes, I guess. But I know it's scattered all over here.
Here's another wagon rim, kind of bent up. Pretty hard to tell where the old trail was. Plus, there's some other old wagon things. I don't know what they are. Maybe they helped the old geezer seat to stay on or something. I don't think you had stirrups on a wagon.
I don't know what Chris is doing, but I hope he's catching fish, having a good time. I'm just really working hard here, as you can see. But I'm thinking about him.
I took one last look in the direction of the old canyon and headed out.
I think we're good.
Good deal.
Well, John, I guess it's okay if I call you by your...
You can call me John.
John, the camp host, was a great guy, and when I told him about my success near the canyon, he was game to go too, so we headed out.
Can I say that you work for the Forest Service and run one of the prettiest campgrounds I've been in?
God, it's my job, that's what I do.
That's what my wife said, and I quote, "That's the cleanest bathrooms I've ever seen." She really appreciated it. That's why I got to bullshitting with you and all of that.
I clean them every day. That's my job. I love it.
Well, good on you.
Yeah.
Well, John got right to work, rigging up in a hurry, and soon he was casting his own Thomas Buoyant out into the current. It wasn't long until he hooked up with a pan-sized trout and brought it in. He released it, and he was back in action, casting into the tail out of the pool.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, there'd be one of them stupid enough to stay buttoned up.
Yep, it happened. Fish on. Big fish on.
No sense horsing him, though. He'd got all the time in the world.
Yeah, I thought I had a log.
Slowly, he gained line and got the fish in close. Don't lose it now.
Yeah. Well, you just, a little bit at a time, ease him towards you, and the battle will get over with.
Hold on and nurse it into the shallows.
Okay, we're about 5 minutes into the battle, and both sides seem to be tiring a little bit.
That's it, that's it. Just ease him up on the bank. Now, just jerk the hook out, and bingo, there he goes.
Ha ha ha, good job.
So we won't tell anybody where we were fishing today, except that it's down in No Tellums Canyon, and it's pretty tough getting down in here.
We dribble creek and all of that.
That's right.
Well, it was fun.
It was fun.
All that was left to do now was get out.